Inhaled nitric oxide is a specialty gas that is used in the field of respiratory care. It is a selective pulmonary vasodilator, which means that it dilates the blood vessels in the lungs without affecting the rest of the body. We created this video to cover the medical definition and provide a brief overview of this topic. So if you're ready, let's get into it. As previously mentioned, inhaled nitric oxide, or iNO, is a selective pulmonary vasodilator that has been studied and utilized for a variety of respiratory conditions. The first is PPHN, or persistent pulmonary hypertension of the newborn. Inhaled nitric oxide has been approved by the FDA for treating PPHN in neonates. It helps to reduce the need for extracorporeal membrane oxygenation, or ECMO, by improving oxygenation and reducing pulmonary vascular resistance in affected infants. Next is ARDS, or acute respiratory distress syndrome. Although not FDA approved for this indication, inhaled nitric oxide has been used off-label for treating ARDS in both adults and children. It may help to improve oxygenation and reduce the need for mechanical ventilation in these patients. Since the gas is a selective pulmonary vasodilator, it may be helpful in treating patients with pulmonary hypertension, as it has been investigated as a potential treatment for various forms of pulmonary hypertension, including chronic thromboembolic pulmonary hypertension and pulmonary arterial hypertension. Studies have shown that inhaled nitric oxide may improve exercise capacity and hemodynamics in these patients. And keep in mind that, at this time, inhaled nitric oxide is not routinely used in the management of respiratory failure associated with prematurity. But you may be wondering, how is it delivered? Inhaled nitric oxide can be administered in newborns with mechanical ventilation by using a specially designed system that is capable of precision drug dosing. The recommended dose for inhaled nitric oxide is 20 parts per million. And when a desired outcome has been achieved, the dose is gradually titrated by 50% increments to reach a final dose of 1 ppm. Then the drug is discontinued. When this happens, the patient may experience a rebound effect and withdrawal symptoms, which can be mitigated by increasing the delivered FiO2. In general, inhaled nitric oxide should be accessible in every hospital with a level 3 intensive care nursery, and it should also be integrated into high-risk transport teams. In addition, non-ECMO centers should have a treatment failure plan that takes into consideration the distance to the nearest ECMO center. So as you can see, inhaled nitric oxide is an important gas for treating newborns who require mechanical ventilation for hypoxemic respiratory failure. If you want to support the channel, please like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. And as always, breathe easy, my friend.